Welcome everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today we are sharing how to cook nasi lemak. This is a very popular street food suitable for all day dining. This recipe is 100% vegan. Nasi lemak is rice cooked with coconut milk. Let's begin with cooking the rice. What we need is 1.5 cup of rice, a piece of cinnamon, 4 to 5 cloves, 3/4 cup of thick coconut milk, 2.25 cup of water, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of sugar, about 3 pandan leaves if it's available. First, you have to rinse the rice a few times until the water turns clear. Drain it well and transfer it to a pot with a heavy base or a rice cooker if it's available. Add in the coconut milk together with 2.25 cup of water. The amount of water depends on the type of rice we are using. The ratio normally is 1:1.5 or 1:2. Next, add in the cloves, the cinnamon, the salt and sugar. Stir everything well. Tie the pandan leaves into a knot. Place it in. Place the lid and cook it over medium heat. Leave it slightly open if it doesn't have a steam releasing hole. Cook it over medium heat for about 10 minutes. It has been cooking for 10 minutes now. Open the lid, stir it lightly to make sure that the coconut milk is well incorporated. Do not overstir. Place the lid again. Seal the steam releasing hole with a piece of paper towel rolled up and stuffed into the hole. Now turn the heat to low and let it cook for another 5 to 7 minutes. Now the rice is cooked. Turn off the heat. Do not open the lid and let it rest for at least 15 minutes. Now we can start cooking the sambal. What you would need is about 7 to 10 dried chilies. The amount depends on how hot the chili is. Cut it into smaller pieces and soak it in hot water for about 30 minutes. 2 large onions, 4 pips of garlic, 1 large tomato, some salt, 1/2 teaspoon of sugar, 2 tablespoons of tamarind, about 3 tablespoons of light cooking oil and water. Drain the dry chilies, rinse it and add it to the grinding jar. You can opt to remove the seeds if you want it to be less spicy. Add in the garlic, add 2 tablespoons of water, place the lid and grind it until it becomes very fine. It should be like this. Transfer it to another container. Do not rinse the jar. Chop up 1 of the onions, place it in the grinding jar, place the lid and grind it coarsely. It should be like this. Dissolve the tamarind in 3/4 cup of water and make the tamarind juice. Now cut the second onion into very thin slices and cut the tomatoes into wedges like this. Heat a wok or a frying pan. Add in about 3 tablespoons of light cooking oil. Once the oil is hot, add in the chili paste. Let it cook for about 2 minutes. Reduce the heat if it's burning too fast. Now this has been cooking for 2 minutes. You can add the ground onion, stir it and let it cook for another minute. Now rinse the jar with some water and add the liquid in. Stir and let it cook for another 2 minutes. Now you can add the tamarind juice. Use your fingers or a strainer to remove the pulp and the seeds. Stir and let it continue to cook for another 3 minutes. Keep stirring it periodically. Add more water if necessary. After 3 minutes, add in the tomato and the onion. Stir and let it cook. Add the required amount of salt. Stir it well and let it cook until the tomato dissolves. Keep stirring it periodically. After cooking for about 4 to 5 minutes, it will look like this. You can see the oil on the surface. Add the sugar, stir, taste it, add more salt if necessary. If you think it's too hot, you can add more tomatoes and let it cook a little longer. Now this is done. Turn off the heat and transfer it to a serving bowl. To complete the nasi lemak, we need some fried peanuts. You need about 3/4 cup of raw peanuts. Heat a wok or a frying pan. Add about a tablespoon of light cooking oil. Add in the peanuts and lightly fry it. Keep stirring it for about 3 to 4 minutes or until it turns golden brown. Turn off the heat, transfer it to a container lined with paper towel and let it cool down. Now the rice has been resting for 30 minutes. Remove the pandan leaves and the spices if you come across them. Use a fork or a pair of chopsticks to loosen and fluff up the rice. Scoop some of the rice and fill a little bowl. Lightly pack it in. Nasi lemak is normally served packed in a banana leaf. If you have banana leaf available, line a plate with the banana leaf. Transfer the bowl of rice on the plate. Nasi lemak is normally served with some cucumber, sambal, fried anchovies, peanuts, fried or boiled egg. This is the basic vegan nasi lemak. Add full boiled egg or fried egg if you consume egg. Nasi lemak goes very well with rendang. Please watch our previous video. We have shared how to cook a simple rendang. We have used very minimum ingredients in all these recipes. You definitely have to try these recipes. Share with us your photos and your comments. Till we meet again soon with another recipe. Vanakkam.
Thank you. Don't forget to like and subscribe.